In the next 3 minutes, three people will develop dementia and two of them will be women. Women may be at much higher risk of dementia when they lose the brain protection of hormones that decline during menopause. As hormones like oestrogen protect brain function, can you actually stop dementia from developing by replacing these hormones lost during menopause? Let's discuss. Welcome to episode 87 of Better Brain, Better You. Hello, I'm neuroscientist Dr. Ben Webb, sharing brain advice for a mentally healthy and happy midlife. Hello there, how are you? Got a really important episode for you today on whether hormone replacement therapy for menopause can actually help to reduce a woman's risk of dementia. So if you want to discover your current risk of dementia, you can take our quick and easy online dementia risk test. It's free and your results will give you a risk score for developing dementia and a six-step plan for looking after your brain health. So you can take this free test at ologyonlinecourses.com/dementia test. That's ologyonlinecourses.com/dementia test. So many of us worry about dementia, particularly if there's someone in our family who's been affected. And there isn't a known cure for dementia, so we as doctors and scientists put all our effort and focus into prevention by taking steps to improve brain health and reduce known factors, which include things like high blood pressure, diabetes, obesity, and smoking. There's also really good evidence that regular exercise, an active social life, and stimulating hobbies that challenge your brain, such as learning a new language or playing a musical instrument, can really help to reduce the risk of dementia and cognitive decline. And in recent years, there's been a lot of research into dementia, and some studies suggest that HRT, so hormone replacement therapy, could potentially reduce the risk of dementia, and specifically Alzheimer's, along with other neurodegenerative diseases like Parkinson's. And women with dementia actually outnumber men by 2 to 1. And it's not yet fully understood why this is the case. And it isn't entirely explained by the fact that women live longer than men. And it's important to say that even though the risk of dementia increases with age, dementia is actually caused by diseases in the brain and not by age alone. And brain scans indicate that the rate at which brain cells die is much faster in women than in men. And some researchers believe that this could be linked to declining levels of the hormone oestrogen during the perimenopause and menopause. And some studies have shown that oestrogen can actually have a protective effect on the brain cell, on your brain cells, which is why researchers are working really hard to assess whether taking HRT could reduce your risk of dementia. And oestrogen affects how your brain grows, how your brain functions, which is why menopause can be a real turning point for your brain health and for your cognitive function, so for your thinking and your memory. And oestrogen stimulates the brain, keeps those neurons firing, supports the growth of new cells, and actually helps existing cells to form new connections with other cells. So when oestrogen levels fall during the menopause, your entire body, including your brain, actually goes into what we call a deprivation state. So there's an overall reduction of brain energy levels during menopause, which is one reason why you can suffer things like hot flashes, night sweats, anxiety, depression, brain fog, and even memory loss, which we know happens a lot during menopause as well. So testosterone has similar functions, but in men it actually declines very gradually over a much more protracted period. And in many cases, men are fertile into old age. But oestrogen really goes away during menopause. Suddenly, your most potent oestrogen is gone. And for some women, it can happen almost overnight. So if you have surgery, and sometimes due to some cancer treatments, then that can be a real shock. So a lot of people view menopause as a natural process that women go through, which is absolutely correct. But they don't view it as a process that puts you at an increased risk of future conditions like dementia. And this is what really matters, and certainly for our discussion today. And as oestrogen supports brain function, there's increasing evidence to suggest that taking HRT, replacing your hormones, could also play a key role in reducing your risk of dementia. So in a recent study, people who took HRT went on to have a 58% lower risk of Alzheimer's, but the greatest benefits were seen in women who had taken HRT for 6 years or more. They were actually 79% less likely to develop Alzheimer's and 77% less likely to develop any neurodegenerative disease, like things like Parkinson's as well. So taking body identical HRT, so that's rather than synthetic hormones, resulted in the greatest reduction of that risk. So HRT administered through the skin in a patch, gel or spray reduced the risk of Alzheimer's, while taking an oral HRT pill reduced the risk of combined neurodegenerative diseases as well. So taking HRT for more than 1 year gave greater protection from Alzheimer's, dementia and Parkinson's disease than any short-term treatment where HRT was taken for less than 1 year. So hormone therapy is not actually a treatment. It's keeping the brain and your whole system functioning, leading to prevention. It's not reversing disease, it's preventing disease by keeping your brain healthy. And some people are at greater risk of developing dementia due to a family history, predisposing condition, or other risk factors. And this is why it's vital to get personalized advice from your doctor before making any decision about HRT. So it's also crucial to look at lifestyle factors that support brain health to help minimize your risk of dementia as well. So this includes eating a healthy diet that's rich in polyunsaturated fatty acids, which are found in things like fish and legumes, taking regular exercise, prioritizing relaxation and reducing your stress levels, and making sure you get enough sleep. So it can be a challenge to make these lifestyle changes on your own, especially if you're not feeling your best. So things like insomnia, aches and pains and fatigue are all really common symptoms of the perimenopause and menopause, but they can be relieved with the correct support and type and dosage of HRT, giving you the energy and focus you need to prioritize your health and well-being. So we already know that improving brain health can help reduce the risk of dementia, and this can be done by eating the right food, exercising regularly, staying a healthy weight, and not smoking or drinking excessively, as I've said already. As an added bonus, taking HRT through the skin via a patch or gel or spray can help to keep cholesterol down and lower your blood pressure as well. So hormone replacement therapy was the standard care for menopause management up until 2002, when perceptions changed following a study by the Women's Health Initiative. This led to fears of breast cancer and heart attacks that were not actually supported by the data. So unfortunately, among many women and doctors, the perception of HRT benefit and risk is distorted, and its use is often avoided, leading to unnecessary distress for many women. So when started within 10 years of menopause, HRT significantly reduces the risk of dementia. So if you want to discover your current risk of dementia, as I mentioned at the top of the show, you can take our free test and get a risk score for developing dementia and a 6-step plan for looking after your brain health. So you can take that test at ologyonlinecourses.com/dementia test. That's ologyonlinecourses.com/dementia test. So thanks so much for tuning in today. I hope today's episode was helpful. Take really good care of yourself, and I will look forward to seeing you next time.